Hey guys, it's Stacy from Star Stuff Travel. Thank you so much for tuning in and joining me during our Travel Talk Live, which we do every Wednesday on our Facebook page, Star Stuff Travel, where we talk about things that we're seeing in the industry, things our agents are doing, things maybe we're seeing with our clients. And today I am so excited to talk about my trip to Hawaii and the experience that I've had preparing for this trip to Hawaii. So we leave tomorrow, and there are some things that you do have to do that Hawaii does require from you when you travel to the islands. So we are personally staying on the island of Oahu, which we love. I actually have been there quite a few times. I'm bringing my husband and my daughter. It's going to be their first time. We actually have family on the island that we're going to be able to see while we're there, so we're very excited. But again, there are some things that are required of you in preparation for your travel to Hawaii, and that's what we're going to talk about today. So there is a travel requirement, which is starting off by visiting the Safe Travel State of Hawaii website. You can find this by Googling. Like I said, you can enter Safe Travels State of Hawaii website. And this is where you're going to start your account. You're going to register yourself, and any adults traveling to the islands actually need their own account. So you're not able, if you're the lead guest and you're the one that does all of the, the planning, if you're obviously using a travel planner, they can help you, but you're going to need to actually do an account for each person that is over the age of 18. You'll register, and they're going to ask some things of you, such as your flight information, what hotel you're staying at, and the hotel address, and things like that. Now, Hawaii does require a negative COVID test 72 hours before your departure. So we are leaving tomorrow at 10 a.m. So we did our COVID test on Monday at 10 a.m. That's 72 hours prior to your departure. Now, unlike some of the other islands, Hawaii does require you to have the test from one of their trusted partners. And their list is not very long like some of the other islands are allowing. So it is also rather expensive to do the testing through one of their travel partners. So we did go with Vault Health, which was $120 per person per test. So we had three people in our travel party. We spent $360 just on the testing to travel to Hawaii. Now, the way Vault works is they send you the test once you register. You pay for it. They send the test to you. You do not open it until the day you're ready to test. And then you actually open it and you do the test on a live Zoom with someone that is watching you. Now, the test is slightly different because they do not require a nasal swab. You're actually spitting into a vial in front of the doctor that's watching you on Zoom. So it is a little bit better for those that don't really care for the nasal swab. The Vault Health does the saliva test. So we did that on Monday. Once we were finished, it was probably about 10 minutes per person, 10, 15 minutes by the time you unwrap the box in front of the doctor and you collect your saliva and you seal it up in front of the doctor. By the time we were done, I would say it was about a half an hour to 45 minutes total for all three of us. And then we headed to the UPS drop-off. You drop them off at UPS. That was Monday. And last night, which was Tuesday, we had the results. So it was barely 24 hours and we had our results. Now, once you have the results, you have to head back over to that Safe Travels State of Hawaii website and you have to upload your negative COVID test to your profile. This is very important. If you do not do this correctly, you will be subject to a mandatory quarantine. I believe it's up to 10 days on the island. And nobody wants to travel all the way to Hawaii and get stuck in your room for that amount of time. So you definitely want to make sure that you're doing all of the steps accurately. So once I received the COVID tests that were negative, we uploaded each one of them onto each one of our accounts. And then 24 hours prior to your departure, you then log on to the website onto your account again, and you complete a health form. The health form is very easy. It literally took 2 moments. It had maybe 4 or 5 questions, just like the normal COVID health questions. Do you have a fever? Are you taking any type of medication that will mask a fever? And things of that nature. So once we were done with the health form, you then receive, this is very important, you receive a QR code to the email that is registered with their website. Why is this QR code important? Well, because when you get off the plane, you are going to be required to show this QR code. And one of my recommendations is, although I know a lot of travelers are traveling with a QR code on their phone, you want to print it out too, because God forbid you can't access your emails on your phone or you don't have internet connection, at least you have the printed out QR code and you're good to go and it's taken care of. So you want to make sure that you have that printed out. That's very important. Another thing that I do suggest when you are traveling to Hawaii is not only printing out your QR code, but also having your travel plans handy just in case they ask. Maybe your hotel reservation number, the dates, and your airline information, because there is a chance they may ask you for this information. So what I do, I'm very old school, is I print everything out and I carry it with me in a folder. This way I have it all where it needs to be. And what I do is I have everything in the correct order, boarding passes, tests, the QR codes, the shuttle when we land, and this way I'm not, you know, going crazy looking for it. Yes, I do always utilize stuff on my cell phone and in my, you know, cloud-based and all that, but I do like to have printed out forms. It really makes me feel better to know that I'm totally covered. So it was about a 3-day process from doing the COVID test to getting the results and uploading them and then doing the health form. But we are done and we've got our QR code and we are ready to go. So when we do get there, we are staying at the Hilton Hawaiian Village, which is in Waikiki, right on the beach. And I'm really excited because instead of doing our normal, you know, hotel room, we did opt for a 1-bedroom villa that has a full kitchen. Why is a full kitchen exciting to you when you're on vacation? I know, believe me, I'm not going to be doing any cooking, that's for sure. But Hawaii is very expensive to dine at. And although we're going to enjoy a luau and some really fabulous dinners, I wanted to be able to utilize the refrigerator and have food for breakfast and for lunch. Now, this leads me to another type of issue that we're running into in the travel world, specifically even on the islands in Hawaii, is the car rental shortage. So most of the car rental agencies in Hawaii did have to sell off their fleet during the pandemic, which is making car rentals either almost impossible to book or find, or just very, very expensive. I mean, you're talking like possibly $3,000 to $6,000 for a week for a car rental if you're lucky enough to find one. So what I did was I did a order through Foodland, which is a grocery store in Hawaii, and they're going to be delivering us groceries approximately between 5 and 7 tomorrow night when we after we land. So we did have the Foodland grocery store delivery dropping off groceries. And because we had the issue with the car rental. Instead of renting a car and touring the island, we are very excited to have booked a couple different tours that will come and pick us up from the hotel and bring us to where we want to go. And to be honest, as much as, you know, you really want to have a car rental in Hawaii, we're looking forward to having someone else do the driving and really just enjoying our time there. So there are definitely ways to get around if you can't rent a car when you're on the island. So we are very excited. We take off tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock in the morning. It is a 10 hour and 48 minute flight from where we are. We're going to be flying from Newark, New Jersey. And when we land, it's going to be 2:47 p.m. in Hawaii. So with that 6 hour time difference, we're going to get most of our day back tomorrow. And although I've been to Oahu quite a few times, I've never done a nonstop flight. I've always stopped in California, stretched my legs, spent a couple days, but tomorrow we decided that we would do a nonstop flight since you do have to have that COVID testing 72 hours from your final leg of your destination. So instead of worrying about testing in California, we just thought it would be better to have a nonstop flight. So that is all I have to share today about our experience getting prepped and ready for our trip to Hawaii. We will be back with tons of footage live and on social media, on Facebook and on YouTube during our trip, throughout our trip, and when we get back. We'll do a whole travel talk live about how our trip actually went and what you should look forward to, what's different pre and post pandemic. So I'd like to thank you for tuning in. If you're watching this on YouTube, definitely hit the like and subscribe button. And if you're watching this on Facebook, definitely follow us on Facebook as well. So thank you so much for tuning in, guys. Have a great day. Thank you.